I don't really have anything new to say about Patek Philippe. You probably already know more about the brand than I do. Patek is well known for its rich history of high horology, and these days, perhaps even more discussed, for its sports watches, like the Nautilus and the Aquanaut. Which is why I want to show you something under the radar and underappreciated. The Patek Philippe Gondolo. This is the 5124G. The G refers to the white gold case, which measures 33 millimeters across, 43 millimeters in length, and a mere 8 millimeters thick. The thin profile is possible due to the 2125 in-house movement being manually wound. And it's a special movement. This engine is specifically designed for the Gondolo line and the rectangular watches that make it up. The 8 millimeter thickness is made even more comfortable by the fact that the 43 millimeter long case is curved and wraps around the wrist. The arcing shape's elegance is enhanced by the stepped flanks of the case, which also acts as a crown guard. And all of this white gold frames a perfect dial. A sunburst blue dial isn't something you see often from Patek Philippe, but they've done as good as you would expect. The hands are in the Dauphine style, which is so common on Calatravas, and are a perfect match for the similarly faceted markers. The small seconds at 6 o'clock has a radial guilloche with printed markers for each second. And maybe my favorite part of the dial is the chapter ring, which is a silvery white and continues the sunburst pattern of the blue. I think that chapter ring frame adds so much to this design than its dimensions suggest. It highlights the blue and forces your attention towards the center of the dial. I think a detail like that is the difference between good and great design. This isn't the most sought-after Patek watch, and it probably never will be, which is why the 5124G is such a great watch. It's not trendy, no celebrities are wearing it, and it probably isn't anyone's grail watch. But it represents so much of why Patek Philippe is legendary that it could be held up as a flagship timepiece. Or rather, it could have been. But Patek discontinued this and all other men's Gondolo watches, so this one is now officially part of the manufacturer's rich past.